I cannot believe how amazing this foundation is for my 52-year-old skin. Pores, dark spots, wrinkles. It is so good. Full coverage without looking like a cakey mess. We need to talk about this foundation right now. Hi friends, I am so excited to bring you this tutorial or this demonstration of this foundation. I have been absolutely blown away with this for over a week. And when I find something that I get excited about that is game-changing or life-changing, I have to bring it to you. I'm bringing you today something that Tati showed on her channel. I'm just like stealing their ideas and making them work for the mature woman and important for the mature woman. Okay, this is a foundation that is Japanese, and it is called Flawless Nude Makeup. First of all, I'm going to tell you that they have crap for a shade range, but I will show you at the end of the video, towards the end of the video, what I use to make foundations darker, and it's going to take you clear to the deepest that you need to, I believe. Sorry about Smuckers. Anyway, this one, I don't remember whether this is the lightest one or whether it's the one next to it, but it's my perfect shade, which is unusual. Okay, so it comes like this. It has, the foundation is kind of in a pan or a pot, and then the applicator has its own cover, and it's just a kind of a mushroom sponge type thing. So it has the handle right here, and then you can dot it around. I have never used this because this is not something that I would normally use on my skin anyway. So I have used a brush and a beauty sponge to put my foundation on. And I say this in the video, but if you haven't seen my video about how I apply foundation from Mr. Wayne Goss, then you definitely need to take a minute and go look at that video. I'll make sure that I throw that up in a card, and I will link it below. And by the way, everything that I'm wearing will be listed and linked below, including I can put my shirt on there. This is a sweater, so I can put that on there for the first time, and I'll try to make sure to do my nails too from Zoya, as always. Okay, so this comes, it's got a twist off lid, and then the makeup is here. Now this is all a piece of plastic or rubber, and then when you push this down, you get the makeup up, and this is kind of just a mess to show you. It has this cool design on there, which is awesome, but it does, you know, if you push it down with your fingers, you're going to get it all over. So what I am so impressed about is the ease of application, the full coverage with just one coat. Well, it's more like medium coverage with one coat, I should say, if you don't use that technique that I talked about with Wayne Goss. I cannot say enough about how long this lasts, how perfected my makeup looks all day long. I don't have any settling into my pores or my fine lines, and it doesn't break apart, which is weird because this is kind of a natural satin finish. If you're super oily, you might not like this, but if you're dry to normal combo, you're going to, I think you're gonna love this because it just works so good. Now, I always have breakup right here on my nose and right here underneath or in the crease of my chin right there, but I don't get that with this. It's just, I can't even begin to explain to you how special this makeup is. So since I can't begin to explain to you how special it is, let's just demo it so you can see how I got this look and you can see how phenomenal the makeup is and how impressed I am by this makeup that Tati demoed right before she went into silence. And I just think that it's so good. Okay, so on one side of my face, I'm going to do my foundation the way I normally do it. And on the other side, I am just going to leave it for the foundation and do it the way that I used to do it, which is how normally most people do it. So if you haven't seen the technique that I did where I talked about the new foundation technique for me, for mature skin that I got from Wayne Goss, you need to go see that. So in Tati's video, she did do a little bit of prep, and that's what I'm gonna do today. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this NYX Marshmallow Primer. I do really like this, but I'm still testing it out. It feels really good on the skin. It sinks in really easily onto the skin. And then right after that, I'm gonna prep this side of my face. I'm gonna prep both under eyes, but I'm gonna prep this side of my face with the Pixi by Petra Color Corrector in, I think this is Brightening Peach. Anyway, I'm gonna put that all over, and I normally do it underneath my eyes no matter what, but I'm also going to, on this side, I'm going to kind of do it across my cheeks to hide a little bit of redness, and then down into this nasal fold part down there. And then I pick up some and I just dot it on places where my age spots are quite different. Say hi to Ollie. He is here joining me as usual. Okay, once I get that all prepped, what I normally do with this new technique is I will take a powder and put that on right now. So I'm gonna do that on this half of the face. This is from Canmake. This is a new powder that I just found that I'm really liking for doing this because it's a lavender powder. And it's just really brightening on my skin. And I do kind of have that dull look to my face. So I'm just gonna lift up some powder and I'm going to go ahead and put it across this half. And I'm gonna make sure I do that under eye area because it covers so much better when I do that, just a little bit there. It's a very finely milled powder. I do like that a lot. It's not like you have to get a ton up to get the effect, and it's really light, like that Becca powder that I just talked about, but not quite as light as that. So I'm just gonna be using my beauty sponge and I'm gonna go into it. It's got like a plastic cover right here and it kind of just squishes up out of there. This is actually a very good color for me. So this side is going to be just the sponge. And since I picked it up with the sponge instead of a finger or anything, I'm just gonna kind of distribute it around with the sponge itself. I don't want too much because obviously that's gonna get you looking cakey. But this foundation is amazing. If you want to try this and you are darker skinned, there is a new mix in medium from NYX that is really dark and it's really beautiful. So you might want to try that out. So that is one coat. It's so beautiful. Even at one coat, if you were looking at light days when you didn't need all that foundation to cover, but I'm going to take a little tiny bit extra on my sponge. And I'm going to do this area right here where I have so many age spots and discoloration. So I'm just trying to cover up this redness right here that I have on my cheeks. And I'm really working this in by pressing it really good. Can you see how that almost takes care of those under eyes anyway? You don't really need another concealer, but I do a little bit because when you look down, you see a little bit of darkness right there. So that is so beautiful. All right, we're gonna move on to the brush. This is a new e.l.f. brush that I found that is angled and it's a great stippling or, you know, buffing brush. And I just take that brush down in there again and just take that makeup onto the brush. Now it gets a little bit more interesting because brushes, normally I don't put the makeup directly onto the brush. I guess I put a little bit, but it's hard to know exactly how much you've picked up with this particular makeup. But look at this. I mean, we're talking flawless complexion. We're talking total coverage without looking heavy and without looking cakey. All of the redness, the dark spots, everything. Now with that color corrector, it just makes it just 10 times more effective down there. And it just covers everything on that first pass, unlike this one without the color corrector. But you don't have to do that. You know, that's what I just do for a preparatory part, and I do take it down my neck and a little bit on my decollete. And yes, it does get a little bit on my clothes, but I'd rather have a little bit on my clothes than show all those nasty age spots that I have from sun damage on there. So there is one spot here that I'm not liking that is really red and it's kind of showing through. It doesn't show on through this side because I did use the color corrector. That's okay. I wanted to show you the two different ways, but it doesn't like completely take that out unless I was to go in and work it again. So I'm going to use just a teeny tiny bit of concealer and we're going to take care of that a little bit. Now we're going to use my favorite concealer at the drugstore. This is from Revolution Pro and it is the Ultimate Coverage Crease Proof Concealer. It's a lot like Tarte's Creaseless Concealer. It's very emollient like It Bye Bye Concealer. I think I've put that in a dupe before. What you need to know about it is you're going to use the tiniest amount you've ever used of concealer. You don't need very much in order for this concealer to really look good and cover the way you need it to. I'm warming it up in my fingers just a little bit. This is a little bit more yellow than the foundation itself, but I like that because I do have the dark circles and I like for them to just go away. I'm just patting that in and I'm getting it to really, really, really be worked in there. And let that set for a second. If you don't set that down with either a setting spray or a setting powder, that is going to crease. That is what this concealer does, but it's super emollient and super coverage for the mature woman. So if you have really dry under eyes, this is amazing, but you might not like it. What I'm licking my finger for is so I can take that apart. It's a tissue, and I'm just gonna use that tissue now, and I'm just gonna go around my face, and I'm just going to take off any excess. This foundation does not completely set down. It is very dewy, even though I don't think it's meant to be, but it is very dewy on my skin. Now that could be because of the way I moisturize like crazy, or it could be because it's just a little bit higher coverage foundation. Either way, this is amazing. So I did take quite a bit off of my under eyes, and I'm gonna do that again. Don't wipe, just press, and you should be fine with that. Okay, if you're an oily skin gal, go ahead and powder now. I'm gonna do that on this side of my face since we're doing the atypical application of foundation on this side of the face. I'm using this new Becca Light Reflect, let's see. It is called Light Shifter Finishing Veil. I've talked about this so much, and I think they sold out of it even at Ulta. And I think that they might have it at Sephora. They might have it at Beautylish. But I know that they had it last time I checked on BeccaCosmetics.com. So if you're interested, I will make sure I leave the link because I didn't last time. So I loaded my brush up a ton. Did you see that? This powder is phenomenal. I put a ton of there on there, and watch. You are not going to see any powder. You can't see any powder. It's just unreal. It's like you just loaded your brush. I saw, watched you go like this a ton, but there's no powder residue across my face. What is up? It's just, it's so pretty. I can't even begin to say enough good about it. So that is the powdered side. This is the side without powder, okay? So it still looks quite dewy. It doesn't look like I've got powder on that's made that side matte at all. And I will just kind of buff this into the cheeks. So I'm gonna use my Benefit Professional Super Setter Long Lasting Makeup Setting Spray, but this doesn't have any oil in it, and it just makes your makeup perfected. When it says professional, it is really true because it does really help with your pores. So I'm just going to take that, and I sprayed this brush, and that's what we're gonna set this side with instead of powder. I pay attention to around my nose and right there around my chin, and I paid attention to that under eye because that concealer was a little bit more dewy. I'm gonna go over this side with what's left on my brush really lightly just to set everything down. And whoa, baby, this is incredibly beautiful. Everything about this, I'm in love with. This foundation makes my skin look so youthful and so nice. And I'm gonna do the rest of my makeup. I'm not gonna do it on camera here with you today, but I'm gonna do the rest of my makeup, and I'll be back to talk to you some more about the foundation and how phenomenal I think it is. Okay, so blush, highlighter, lipstick, a bottom lash line, and it's finished. But this foundation is phenomenal. I just can't get over it. It's crazy how good it is. And for the price, I just think, wow, I'm just absolutely blown away. It makes me want to try others from Amazon and see if some of those other brands, maybe that has a better shade range, would be good. I'm just really excited about this and really can't believe what this does for my mature skin. Now, I have worn this for a week straight. I wanted to test it in every possible way I could, without primer, with primer. It doesn't really matter. Without primer, it's not as good for my skin, but if you're somebody that doesn't like primer, you might really, you know, just enjoy this because it stays on all day long. It's not going anywhere. It blurs, it doesn't settle into my pores, it doesn't accentuate my pores, it doesn't make me look older or cakey or anything like that. Throughout the day, I'm still gonna have a dewy, glowy look to my skin. It is a very natural finish. So if you're somebody that loves a matte finish, this might not be for you, but I'm so impressed, and I cannot believe how phenomenal this does. And when I take this off at night, I am shocked at how beautiful it still looks. My eye makeup, lips, cheeks have faded, but that makeup is still there and is still going strong. And I'm in love. I'm absolutely in love and I can't say enough good about it. Like I said, it does really not have a bunch of shades. So if you're interested, the NYX Total Control Pro, these are actually mix-in drops that won't change the texture of the foundation, but definitely will change the foundation to be darker. I mean, look how dark it is. So it's really great as far as, this one is called Dark. So it's really great as far as how it helps the foundation to go whatever shade you need to, as deep as you need to, without changing the consistency of the foundation. Now I'm gonna show you how light that is. It's super duper light. I don't need these. I got them thinking that there might be a foundation that I could use them in, but I really don't need them myself. I use the blue one more. But look, it's not orange. There's no orange in there. So it's just darkness. It's not gonna be something that turns it orange or that you're gonna have a problem with. So I really like those as well. But if you're somebody that has trouble getting them light enough, LA Girl has a mix in pigment that's really good as well, and it's just pure white. So that one for us lighter skin gals, and then the darker skin gals are taken care of as well. So thanks so much for spending a part of your day with me today. I hope everybody is doing well. Please take care of yourselves, stay happy, stay healthy, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, friends.